Hi and good morning. I greet to everyone. For STF1043 Aquatic Chemistry, our group will explain more about the bioaccumulation of heavy metal in muscle tissue of aquatic organism. This project is represented by our member with guide from Tafara. As introduction, bioaccumulation has its own definition. Bioaccumulation is an increase in the concentration of a pollutant from the environment to the first organism in a food chain. Let's see another term, biomagnification. It is defined as increase in concentration of a pollutant from one link in a food chain to another link in the same food chain. Generally, bioaccumulation is that how pollutants entering a food chain in many ways they can. While biomagnification is the tendency of pollutants in the concentration as they move from one trophic level to the next trophic level. What we must know, even a small concentration of chemical in our environment, they can find many ways to get into the organism in high dosage to cause the problems. Another fact that we must keep alert for the sake of our environment are heavy metal cannot be degraded. They deposited, assimilated or incorporated in water pollution in water bodies. Some factors that may influence heavy metal uptake by aquatic organisms and human itself. First of all, the sex of the consumers. Next, the age of the consumers. Next, the size of consumers, no matter how big or small you are. Then, the reproduction cycle of the consumers. And not to forget the feeding behaviors of the consumers. Let's move to another part. How do heavy metal enter the muscle tissue of aquatic organisms? Metals are introduced to aquatic system as a result of weathering of soil and rocks. Those are from volcanic eruption and from variety of human activities involving mining and processing. Some common heavy metal are arsenic, cadmium, chromium, copper, nickel, lead, and mercury. pH level of water decreases as metal solubility increases. Metal has particulates form, including labile and non-labile fraction. The higher the metal concentration in environment, the more it may be taken up and accumulated by fish. Metal accumulation in fish depends on pollution and is different from various fish. Environment factors that affect the uptake of heavy metal in fish are water temperature and pH level. At high temperature, uptake of heavy metal in the liver and kidney is high. Low pH level will make the accumulation of heavy metal higher. Some processes that show how the heavy metal being consumed. First, the small organism will consume the heavy metal. Then they will be eaten by fish, then the big fish. Some example: accumulation of methylmercury in fish. Then the microbes undergoes anaerobic respiration, sulfate reduction. They use the sulfate, then excrete the sulfide. Mercury ions will bond with negatively charged sulfide that will cause mercury sulfide. Sulfide helps mercury get into the cell. It gets methylated in the bacterial cell. Then they will release the methylmercury. Plus they will be taken up by phytoplankton, then fish, then the big fish. Who will be exposed more to heavy metal? First, the size of the aquatic organisms that are more exposed to have high concentration of heavy metal in their body are the big size organisms, such as shark, swordfish, and the king mackerel. Which organs that have high concentration of heavy metal? Mostly are the liver, the gills, the intestine, and stomach. Not to forget the skeletal muscle. These are effects of heavy metals to humans as consumers of fish. Arsenic, which has high toxic content, can cause malfunctioning of respiration, cell enzyme, and mitosis. Lead, which is high in toxic, can poison us, easily lead us to death. Also, high exposure to lead can cause anemia, kidney, and brain damage. Next, the mercury. Mercury can cause fatal injury to the brain, immune system, kidneys, and liver. How to overcome the problem? We can close down the factories near the river. Next, we will use the natural fertilizers for farming near the riverside. We should avoid disposal of chemical liquid in the drain. Next, we will have people to realize the danger of heavy metals towards human. And last but not least, reduce the water pollution. Thank you.